Adjo, the founder and the head cook at Augusta Peaks Nigeria. I am a wife, a mother, and I'm a graduate of Public and International Affairs. That's my second degree, and I also have a diploma in child nutrition. I'm a head cook. I make food for children, and I'm also an author of a recipe book. Okay, so I had my son abroad. Actually an interesting one, and he is my first son. So my husband and I, as it is usual for a first-time mother, to buy all sorts of food, diapers, everything for him, you know, being the first. And so what we wanted to do was buy all the jar food he needed, because I just felt, okay, a child, you know, would, if a child is eating all those jar foods, he's feeding better. So I mean, we had to buy all those different flavors of food, foreign foods for him. And then when we returned to Nigeria, when he clocked 6 months, he refused all of the food. So we're like, wow. So I mean, does it mean that he's gonna starve? Because I needed to resume work, so I had to start looking for alternatives for him. He was an interesting man, and that was because I love to cook. I like food myself. So as I was eating my good food, I was making my jojo frittata for myself, for instance, I was finding alternatives for my son. So because it was really worrisome that there is no food in Africa that we can be proud of that a child can eat. So, you know, I started making the alternatives. And when I started, I realized that there were quite a number of babies who didn't like food as well. I mean, they were hungry because the mommy will give formula today, the baby will reject it, they will give a radio, he will spit it out. So it became a source of worry to a lot of mothers like me. So, and that was how Augusta Peaks started. So Augusta Peaks started basically by meeting needs of mothers who had children who didn't like to eat. So it's basically started to be a company that will provide 100% natural and innovative food for children, from weaning to school lunches, that is from 6 months to 5 years. Okay, with my son, okay, so let me share the experience with my son. He actually did not just like the taste of pre-made food. Okay. So, and because along the line, you know, starting my course in child nutrition, I realized and I learned that it is a general knowledge that, look, natural foods are twice as nutrient rich than pre-made foods. So that means that I needed to help him to get used to natural foods as much as possible. But that was not even the issue. I mean, that was not the major issue. The issue is that even the natural foods, he doesn't like to eat them. I mean, it's not everything you give to a child that the child would like. So for a child to like food, you need to come down to their level. That's the first thing, to understand that, look, mommy, I've been taking breast milk for 6 months. What's the meaning of this image that you are putting in my mouth? What do you mean by carrot puree? So you need to come down to their level, say, hi baby, there is something else after this breast milk, because you actually need it. So because our breast milk doesn't contain, you know, with time, it does not contain enough nutrients for the babies as they grow. So because these babies grow, they don't, I mean, they're not static, so they grow. So as they do, the vitamin D, the iron, and some of the essential nutrients that breast milk contains that could actually help them grow, that was enough for them, is no more enough. So what do? You begin gradually. You begin to come down to their level, make it fun, make it interesting, put yourself in their shoes. So don't say, because I'm eating a bowl of eba, then let me say, okay, I'm 30 years old and my baby is 2. So let's divide the bowl of eba by 30. And then so that means he has to take like half a bowl of eba or maybe 3 spoons of eba. No, it doesn't work that way. We need to come down to their level and understand their nutritional needs. Okay. You know, that way we'll be able to get them to like the foods. Okay, for growing babies, we have certain nutrients that are actually globally lacking. So, and that's because these are nutrients that actually build their brains. So we have this issue where, you know, children just grow in body size, okay, because they eat rice, they just grow, they just grow tall. But what about the brain development? So number one nutrient that a child actually needs to grow properly, especially from weaning, when they start taking solids, the first one is iron. It helps to build the blood, it helps to build the brain, it really helps to actually aid the growth. And also, the babies also need protein. Babies need protein. Basically, I must say, we're just taking this according to the order of priority. Babies actually need all the nutrients to grow. That's just it. I just say that. They need everything. They don't need any diets. They don't need to say, oh, okay, we need to cut off this from our diet. We don't need excess fat. Babies need all the nutrients. So, but iron, protein, calcium, all of these minerals just top the chart. So that's just different. But babies actually need all of the nutrients they can get from food. So for a skinny child, so let's begin from a skinny child, because usually when babies start, when babies stop breastfeeding, so breast milk is actually high in fat and some very good nutrients that actually help babies to maintain their weight.
Okay.
So the moment they get to 6 months, 7 months, 8 months, they outgrow those nutrients, so they need to supplement, and that is where complementary foods come in. So if the foods are, I mean, if eating the solids, I mean eating generally goes wrong, the baby begins to lose weight. So what do? You begin to get foods that actually help the baby to maintain their weight. So you will need to get foods that are high in fat. You need to get foods that are high in, like I said earlier, babies need all the nutrients they can get. They are just, the priorities are just different. So we need to say, okay, let's say liver. Liver will, for instance, not make a baby necessarily gain weight, but it will help the baby to maintain his regular weight. So if a child is skinny, first thing to worry about is, the child may look skinny to you, but is the child actually reaching his weight milestones? Have you put the child on the scale to see if the child is actually losing weight or is just on the slim side? Whatever source of worry, the first place to go is the hospital. It's not to say, oh, I think my baby is skinny now, take the child to the hospital. Okay, I think my baby is too big, take the child to the hospital. So in order to take the child to the hospital, the doctor is able to tell you, oh, okay, I think this baby is too big. Then you now begin to give foods that are actually normal. Usually, what causes babies to actually become bigger than proportion is actually processed foods. Regular natural foods that are good, like I said, we just give the baby, we just make the baby grow at their normal weight. So the moment the baby is obese, and we need to check, maybe the baby is taking the wrong foods, maybe the baby is taking adult foods, overly processed foods. So that's actually the thing with skinny and big babies. Okay, so the beginning of complementary food is not the end of breastfeeding. Complementary food is just to support breastfeeding. So that means that part of the baby's essential diet every day, even if the baby is 6 months upwards. So some people decide to breastfeed exclusively till 7 months. So that means that the moment you start complementary feeding from 7 months, you are saying that I am only adding solids to my baby's diet. I'm only increasing my baby's food varieties. So that means that breastfeeding will be breakfast, solids will be midday food, breast milk again at lunch, breast milk again after lunch, then maybe solids for dinner. Gradually from 2 servings, we'd increase to 3 servings, to 5 servings, up until the baby is actually completely weaned of breast milk at 2 years old. Okay, so we actually have, the truth is, most of the snacks out there are actually highly processed, and they're high in sugar, which actually spikes the blood sugar and causes diabetes, causes some other diseases that, you know, those diseases before now, we used to say, oh, okay, it's just common with adults.
Yes.
Cancer is actually, we have childhood cancer, we have childhood diabetes now. So, and these are actually caused by artificial seasonings, artificial addition of sugar, salt, you know, these are the things that actually begin to damage the child's system, and it's actually a cause for worry. But that being said, that does not mean that sugar and some of those processed foods are actually poisonous, bad for the child. So that means that once in a while, it is okay for our children to actually have the snacks. We have not said they are bad, we are only saying that if it becomes a daily food, if it becomes a daily attitude, so that means that out of, so my baby snacks every day, my child begins to snack every day or needs to snack every day. So I need to put biscuits and drinks in my child's lunchbox to school. I will not be available up until 6 p.m. How about we put yogurt and popcorn, for instance? So that means that out of 100%, your baby needs to snack 100%. How about we make 60% of it natural
okay.
and make 40% of it processed and then maybe I don't care kind of meals, just buy biscuits by the roadside or buy sweets by the roadside. Candy is there. They are okay for children. It's okay for children to have candy.
Okay.
That's true. I'm not of the opinion of, oh, okay, just go complete. The children are not on diet, for Christ's sakes.
Okay.
They are not on a diet. So let's allow them have the candy. Let's allow them have the biscuit. But it shouldn't be too much because there is a consequence and there is a repercussion for these things. So we have other healthy snacks, and that's always the question. You mean to say, okay, my child shouldn't have biscuits. So what other healthy snack can my child take then?
Mm-hmm.
So we have popcorn, for instance. Popcorn is basically popped up corn, and corn is high in fiber, corn is high in carbohydrates, and also proteins as well, and even fats. So, and they're natural, they're not processed. So if the corn is popped and then you just add a little bit of sugar and cinnamon, that way it is healthier than just the regular. So then we also have yogurts, we also have some cookies that you know, that are actually good. So not all packaged foods are bad. First is carbohydrates. So what do we have? We have plantain, we have rice, we have yam, we have couscous, we have bread.
Okay,
and then the proteins, we have eggs, we have meat,
yeah,
we have fish, we have grains,
okay,
you know, like corn, like guinea corn. Okay, so that means that, okay, let's go to the fat and oils. We have coconut oil, we have olive oil, we have butter, we have
avocado,
you know, those are sorts of oils. Then we have minerals. So we have foods that are rich in iron, foods that are rich in calcium, like milk, like liver, like spinach. And somehow, for vitamins and minerals, they are kind of interwoven, because fruits are actually very, very high in vitamins. So we have vitamin A, that is good for the eyesight. And then we have the same carrots, for instance, and oranges that contain vitamin A and vitamin C are equally very helpful in absorbing iron.
Okay.
So you can see that if you have a lot of, if the child has lots of vitamin A and vitamin C, indirectly gets more iron. So rather than bother yourself, I mean, as a mother, you don't have time to find out all of this. Just remember that you need vitamins, just remember fruits,
okay,
minerals, just remember vegetables.
Okay.
And that's it.
Okay.
Foods that are actually rich in fiber and that digest easily. Foods that are rich in fiber help you to aid metabolism and then you make them poo easily. So we have orange. Fresh oranges is very good. Usually, the truth is, mothers usually use fresh oranges as a curative measure, not a preventive measure. So as much as possible, it's not only when the baby's poo is hard or the child's poo is hard that we should serve oranges. From 8 months, from 10 months, it's actually very good to serve fresh oranges,
okay,
for children into their cup, and just give them to drink, and it helps them also get used to the natural, you know, juice, taste of juice, so they won't have to rely on sugary foods all the time. Then we also have beans. Beans is actually also a very good source of fiber. We have banana. Banana is also a very good source of fiber. We have oatmeal as well.
Okay.
In my experience, especially for children, my little experience, I must say, for children, reading nutrition facts label, I just have one statement. Look out for food ingredients that you know. Okay, the truth is, you might not know all of the ingredients.
Mm-hmm.
Now, there are some ingredients that have very long names and they are actually good. Don't even bother. Just try to look for ingredients, whatever food you're picking, ingredients like water, ingredients like oats, ingredient like, you know, let's say butter, at least you know it.
Okay.
As much as possible, that is actually how to interpret. For the layman, that is the best way to interpret nutrition facts label. You don't want to pick a food or a food item that about 6 of the ingredients are actually strange. I mean, how do you know? And then sometimes, you know, the labels tell you, okay, so you have 6 strange names, and maybe the only ingredient there is water. And then eventually, you see that, okay, it's food, and they tell you it is rice. How come it is a rice meal, or it is a rice cake, and there is no rice as one of the ingredients? That's where you should get worried. So if they say it's a rice cake, or it is a rice porridge, at least look out for rice and water. So far, the child is not overweight or underweight. There is nothing to worry about for a child. So you can't say, yes, of course, a child can have too much fat.
Okay.
A child can have too much protein. It is essential for us to worry about their balanced diet. So that is the only thing to worry about. There is no need to worry about their weight if they are actually not overweight.
Okay.
There is no need to worry about their weight if they are not underweight.
Right.
So if you're worried about their weight, use the scale or go to the hospital.
Okay.